Hello, and welcome to the August edition of Sparrow News. Today, we'll visit with a Sparrow superstar, learn about a very special patient anniversary, and so much more. So stay tuned. Sparrow is proud of our doctors and their contributions they make to the community, like Dr. Syed Hussein, Medical Director of Stroke Services at Sparrow. He was among the first physicians in Michigan to use the solitaire flow restoration device used in the brains of stroke patients. Tell me a little bit about the solitaire flow restoration device.
It's known as a stent-triever or a stent-retriever. What this is a stent that is deployed into a blood vessel to open it up so that flow is restored immediately. But then we have the capability to slowly collapse that stent, partially resheath it, and pull it out of the body with any remaining clot still lodged within it. And this is the first of many that have been recently approved for use worldwide and was approved by the FDA to be used here earlier this year.
The Sparrow Stroke Center is a national leader in stroke care and is the only facility in the region accredited as a primary stroke center by the Joint Commission on Accreditation of Healthcare Organizations. And our commitment to innovation to stroke care doesn't stop there. Now patients are benefiting from our affiliation with Hayes Green Beach Memorial Hospital. Hayes Green Beach is working with Sparrow to establish emergency stroke and heart attack protocols. In every community, there are individuals whose exceptional behavior enable them to get better results than their peers. Sparrow has a number of superstar caregivers who keep their eye on patient care. In the second of our regular series, we visit Jonathan Underhill, an RN in the pediatric emergency room. So what sort of superpowers do you have?
Yeah, I have the power to dispense popsicles at a moment's notice.
Oh, that's excellent. Yeah. So how long have you worked for Sparrow?
Almost 17 years now. I started as a valet attendant.
As a small child.
As a very small child, yes. Thank you. Very kind.
You're working with kids a lot.
Mm-hmm.
It just seems like that would be so tough.
Absolutely not.
Why is it not?
Well, kids don't have agendas. They don't have ulterior motives. Are so much more resilient than I am, than you are, than the rest of the adults. I mean, they bounce back so fast, they heal so quick, and they still have a positive outlook. You know, it's like, okay, if I do this, I'm gonna get better, cool. Let's do it, let's get it over with. You know, and they're scared for a little while, but they forgive so much faster than you and I do too. You know, I haven't met a kid that's held a grudge for very long. There's days. Got pretty good about leaving it here. I mean, there are days that, like I said, they're truly tragic days, and they're sad, and there's nothing you can do about it. And I go home, and I pick up my kids, and I hug them. I go, Daddy, what's wrong? Nothing, I love you.
Sparrow is proud to have superstars like Jonathan in our organization that align with and support our culture. Sparrow continues to prepare for the iSparrow EMR launch on Saturday, December 1st, 2012. And you can prepare too by participating in various training classes held September through November on all four hospital campuses. To help encourage our caregivers to participate, we've created a fun way to win great prizes when you complete 6 milestones. Register at isparrowrewards.com. Registration is the first milestone, so sign up today. Local medical research recently received a very exciting boost. Sparrow has helped form the Sparrow Clinical Research Institute that will specialize in conducting clinical trials on drugs, devices, and medical strategies, giving physicians and their patients access to cutting-edge technology. So the institute itself was separate from Sparrow for the last 20 years, and now it's incorporated within the health system?
Sparrow has always had the goal to be a major research center in the mid-Michigan area, and that's why they look to us, because we have the structure and the knowledge to base that from. So they want to build on what we have and make it into a major research center in the area.
The institute will put Sparrow into the forefront of a lot of medications and medical devices for international research.
The Sparrow Clinical Research Institute will be located close to Sparrow, and once established, will hold meetings with physicians to explain how the organization can work with them to provide leading-edge treatment. And here are some dates of upcoming events that you might want to check out. Anniversaries are a special time for many people, but for Sheila Ballier-Miles of Aurelius Township, her anniversary has even more meaning. This month, she celebrates the 5th anniversary of the brain surgery that saved her life.
First, it started out as headaches about 4 months in advance. And when I went to different doctors, they didn't know what was going on. And so they just thought I had migraines. And about 4 months later, it really started to progress with my balance and motor skills. And so finally, they put me in for a CAT scan and they found the tumor. I can remember a good portion of everything. And the journey was just remarkable. Well, actually, I have gone back, and I have talked to two or three of the people that worked with me, and I have thanked them and hugged them and just said, look at me now. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Sheila credits the Sparrow caregivers in neurosurgery, step-down, and rehabilitation with giving her the will and the tools to thrive after her surgery. It's the kind of care that Sparrow is known for, and it embodies our eye care values. Well, that wraps up the August edition of Sparrow News. Thanks for watching, and be sure to join us next month when we bring you more news from Sparrow.